What is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, you are going to be sitting in on one of my late night makeup sessions. So I feel like this is an intimate moment that we're having because listen, I get asked a lot, you know, how am I able to try so many products and how am I able to confirm my feelings and thoughts on products when I only try them on camera? The secret to me being a successful review channel is for my late night makeup play sessions where for the end of the night, I sit in my makeup room like the makeup goblin that I am, swatch things all over my body. I play with a lot of my products in this time. Like, I don't really care how the makeup look turns out, but I just play with the products that I need to get a feeling for. I've been in the mood to play with some new makeup. I've had a number of products sitting in my collection that I am eagerly waiting to try. Here we are. It's 9 o'clock at night, which is not that late, I'm aware, but for me, that's pretty late. I'm a morning person, not an evening person. It's not common that you will find me in front of the camera at this time, but I thought it'd be fun to just play with some makeup. Before we get into it, let's talk about today's sponsor for the video. This video is very kindly sponsored by shopmissay.com. Full circle moment here because shopmissay was actually the very first company to send me a PR package, period, ever. And I'm going to be talking about a product that they sent in that very first PR package where it opened up a whole new world of affordable makeup sponges. If you've never heard of Shop Missay before, they are a website where the majority of their products are $1. They do have some products that are more than $1, but a lot of them have a charitable component to them. They sell accessories, makeup, skincare, beauty tools, lifestyle stuff. And it's nuts because everything is like $1. They have their own brands like AOA Skin, AOA Studios, OKI. My favorite things to get from them are the beauty tools, particularly this Pawpaw Wonder Blender. So I'm going to talk more about this when we get to it. But if you're a makeup artist, you need to listen to the tip that I have for you and it'll be game changing. So thank you to Shop Missay for sponsoring today's video. Let's get into the makeup. So I get a lot of PR packages from Revlon. I find their stuff is hit or miss. Find that they have products that can be really underrated. But I have this primer and they have a lot of products from this Rose Glow kind of line. So this is the Photo Ready Rose Glow Face Gloss. This just looks delightful. I like a glowy face product. The style of this video, by the way, is probably not going to be as professional as I normally have it. Like I said, I just felt like playing with makeup and turned the camera on. It felt right. Ooh, okay. I have another face primer from Revlon that I don't really like quite as much. I like this. This feels really great and hydrating. It leaves behind a very subtle glitter on the skin, which I normally don't really like, but this feels really nice and hydrating. It's already sunk into the skin. It says it's 80% water. I mean, it didn't make my skin look glossy. They added something, and I like the way that it feels. I like this. This is my favorite Revlon primer that I've tried thus far. This is 2 minutes into wear, but immediately, I like this a lot better than the other primer that I recently tried. Foundation. Haven't tried this yet, but a few weeks ago, I did a haul, and I ordered this Oxygenating Foundation because I heard it was just like amazing and lightweight. It felt like nothing on the skin and I wanted to get a piece of that. I wonder why I get acne and then it's because I put all this stuff on my face. Look at this. Ugh. It's not as bad as it looks. Honestly, the acne is going away. It's just scarring a little bit. Basically heard that this is a breathable formula. So breathable that they even put it on the label, apparently. So I picked this up from Dermstore and they're really awesome. Dermstore is really awesome for clean beauty brands and I was really excited to find this because you can't find this anywhere. And to apply this, I'm going to be using my AOA Studio Pawpaw Blender from Shop Missay. Now you can see this is $1.55 because proceeds are donated to animal rescue shelters. Not bad for $1.55, so it comes in just this cute, adorable packaging. I love it. I've gone through quite a few of these. Like I said, the very first PR package I ever received, was from Shop Miss A, and it contained this makeup sponge, and it was game-changing. I love some more pricey sponges, if you know who I'm talking about. But when I discovered these, it really made me wonder, why do we spend upwards of $20 on a beauty sponge when this is kind of like a dollar, right? This is equally the softest and most affordable makeup sponge that I found on the market. I've tried a lot in my time. It feels exactly like the more expensive sponges. And here is my makeup artist tip for you. So when I first started doing clients, I don't like makeup brushes as far as applying foundation. This was my solution because I'm not buying no $20 makeup sponge for each client. And if you are only using one sponge for multiple clients, stop that right now. Not sanitary. So I order a bunch of these. I actually sell these in multi-packs, and I cut them in half for each client. I just use the half and then I give it to them at the end, and what, that's like 75 cents per client, if even, and they really appreciate it, and it helps my makeup black application. So that's my makeup artist tip. Same for you guys. Don't spend $20 on a makeup sponge. Don't spend $6 on a makeup sponge. These are really great for a dollar. So anyways, here's what it is. This is how it is compared to my hand. And I have the size of a child's hand. I am going to get this wet and I'm going to show you the size difference. Okay, she's wet now. You can see we grew a little bit. Let's start applying this foundation here. Hopefully it's the right color. It's kind of not, but that's okay. It's a little dark. Oh no. So a tip that I have for you if you do purchase this sponge is to buy it in bulk, because honestly, I feel like these are sold out all the time because they're just so popular and so good. You can't beat the value of it. Dang, I wish I bought a better color of this foundation, but but anyways, like I said, you can pick this up at shopmissa.com. So they have a whole bunch of other beauty products like makeup, skincare, fun stuff to check out, super cheap, super affordable. But their beauty tools, I'm telling you, are where it's at. Sometimes I'll pick up lashes from them as well. They have some really great options if you're a makeup artist. Just so affordable. You would not know that this was $1.55 if I handed this to you. Just did a great job of blending the makeup. So if you are interested in checking out this sponge and the Shop Miss A website, I will have it linked down below. You don't have much to lose. So yeah, I just wanted to share that with you guys. Really excited that I was able to talk about this product because I haven't been able to talk about it recently. I did mention it in a live and you guys were like, wait, what sponge? It's this sponge. The foundation looks pretty good, minus the fact that this is not my color. Okay, this actually would work for me really well in the summer, so it's not a complete loss. It's not like glowy or anything, but it looks really lightweight and it feels super breathable. Like, I agree. I literally don't feel like I'm wearing anything. The finish is nice. It's like a demi matte, I would say. I mean, it's not really hydrating looking, and it maybe it looks a little dry, but it feels like nothing. Okay, so far so good, but I'm definitely gonna have to continue playing with this. By the way, the majority of these items that I'm using were in my PR stash, so most of them were gifted to me. I've just been really needing to try them out. So I have these Maybelline Express Brow Pencils, and they're interesting. It says it's a 2-in-1 powder pencil. Like, look at this. We'll start off with soft brown. Something a little less intense. I think I might have 2 hours of footage filming in this mood. Oh, the packaging's kind of cute and rounded. So it looks like we have a kind of thick angled tip. It's on the other side. Oh, is this powder? I think the powder is in the cap. How does this work? So step one, you fill it in with the pencil. And then step two, use the powder. Oh gosh, I don't know if this product, I'm gonna like it, but let's see. Honestly, the pencil's not bad. I kind of wish it was a little creamier because I feel like I'm not getting a super even application of it. And I'm not a big fan of the shape. It's not bad because I have some Maybelline eye pencils that I've tried that I really despise. So I don't despise, no, actually I don't like it. This foundation feels weird, like kind of sticky. Like, it feels good on my face, but when I literally touch it with my hands, I don't know anymore. I don't know about these brows. I told you guys, I sometimes turn out in these late night sessions with a not very cute look, and today arguably might be one of those times. Okay, do I have time for this at this time of evening? I don't. Ah, my patience is running thin. I don't got time for eyebrows. Let's try this powder side. Not that I feel like I need anything else, but kind of scared. That made my brows look patchier, I think. Okay, I'm not gonna write this product off because I think there might be some user error happening, but this is a weird product. I don't know. I don't think I like it. Okay, we'll definitely need to continue playing with this because I don't like the way my brows look, but I think I need to read the directions on the back. Has anybody talked about this brow pencil? I don't think so because I don't like it. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so I got this insane PR package from Catrice. I'm really excited because look, okay. Hello, and then wait. Oh my gosh, I have dreamed of makeup brands sending me a full line of all of these colors, which, you know what, it is a huge waste, but I hope I love this concealer because then I can put these shades in my makeup kit, so it won't be a waste on me. So you better be good. But this is the True Skin Concealer, which is the companion to the True Skin foundation that Miss Tati made very popular, which truthfully, I don't even really like that foundation. I could see a formula similar to that being good as a concealer. I have no clue what color to pick. This looks okay. Warm vanilla. Let me read the other colors we have. Cool rose. Well, we'll go warm because of the base color that I have. Oh, I hope this is good because I have so many colors. And I was looking for this on Ulta. And I think this concealer's hard to get a hold of. Anyways, I'm like super pumped about this. Thank you, Catrice, for sending this to me. Okay, this is a good color. Good job, Morgan. I like my concealer's not too brightening, but like a shade lighter. I mean, honestly, for every day, this probably isn't my perfect shade, but with this foundation, it's fine. Back to my sponge, blending out the makeup so easily. This looks pretty. I'm not mad at that. Okay, let me continue. What do we think? It did a good job. It's not luminous or anything. It doesn't seem to be super hydrating. So I think if you need something really hydrating under the eyes, maybe not the formula for you. I don't know. It looks good so far. We'll see how it wears. That's really where the truth lies. So far it looks really good because I think the formula has so much potential. Want to like brighten up right here. It looks kind of dull. You know what? Let's actually test. Let's see how it would do on the party I have going on my face. Does it cover? It seems to have pretty good coverage. So I like it so far. The textures and the consistencies of the skin products that I've tried today, I really don't feel like I need to set my face, but I want to try this, so I'm gonna do it anyways. This is the Bare Minerals Original Mineral Veil. So this is very much not new. It could honestly probably be older than me. Yeah, this is just translucent. I have a lot of Bare Mineral stuff in my collection waiting to be tried because when the holiday season is less crazy, I want to do a full face of Bare Minerals. And I thought, let me get started on trying some of their products. So we're gonna start off with this guy. A classic powder, truly. I remember that Bare Minerals infomercials, I used to be entranced by them as a child. They used to play all the time. And I didn't know I liked makeup at that point in my life. But there was something about the transformation of the mineral foundation. So it was like a loose foundation. And I loved watching the transformations. This looks really good. I think it kind of blurred my skin a little bit. It's kind of hard to tell because I'm not familiar with any of the products on my face, but I think I liked that powder. Did a good job of doing what powders do. Here's another Bare Minerals product that I am breaking out to test. So this is a bronzer in Faux Tan. Let's see. I'm liking this iconic London brush. Random, but I like it. It's really soft and it's great for applying the outer three of my face. Oh my gosh. My face is gonna be orange. So just ignore that because I'm not putting any foundation on my neck before I go to bed. I always forget to take my makeup off of my neck. So let me not do that to myself. It does not look like a bronzer color that I like. I think in my summer color, this is fine. If I had a foundation that was truly my skin color right now, my feelings might differ. It's fine. I wouldn't say it's my favorite formula. I didn't blend seamlessly like some of my favorite bronzers, but she got the job done. Okay, we gotta move on to the eyes because I have a lot of palettes in my collection that I need to play with, but right now I just can't get through them because the amount of holiday palettes that have come out, it's amazing. I love it. I'm having so much fun, but my to-do list for my palettes has really kind of backed up. I wanted to finally try my Melt Cosmetics Brunette Palette, and I have a love-hate relationship with Melt Cosmetics. Sometimes their palettes are fire, amazing, and the color story, but then the quality sometimes is not good. It's literally like 50-50. I either love it or I hate it. So I picked this one up because I figured it's neutrals. Like, they can't mess this one up, right? So the packaging's kind of not as cute as their normal packaging, and this has been out for months. It's long forgotten in the makeup community at this point with how fast-paced we are. But you can see this shade right here, Stout, came a little broken. I had to press her in. But let's start off with Suede. Got a little bit of kickback. Like I said, this video is unprofessional, okay? We're gonna brighten our underbrow. Nice! I mean, you can see that lifted the eyebrow. Okay, so we're gonna do Cork next. I'm gonna do a really basic look just so I can really see if I like these shadows or not. So this is going to be our transition color. Taking a Rephr number 1 brush, we're gonna go a little bit deeper into tan right here. And I'm just gonna put this in the outer corner. Like so. So far, so good, you guys. I'll be honest, I kind of expected this palette to be good because of the nature of these colors. Most, not all, but most brands don't really mess up a neutral palette. You guys know I do all of these crazy looks, but at the end of the day, I'm still the most comfortable in a brown makeup look. I love a brown makeup look. Let's just do it with brunette, the darkest matte brown. And I'm gonna really focus this right in this outer V area, right here. Softly blend it. Then I want it to be a little bit more intense along the lower lash line. Basic as it is, this is a good, easy blend that I had. But we must play with the shimmers because that's where Melt messes up a lot sometimes. So we'll start off with Stout right here, the shadow that broke. We're gonna put this on the center of the lid. So it does feel a little bit stickier, which makes it look a little bit more textured on the lid, but you definitely kind of have to press hard into the pan and work it a little bit. It's not gonna apply with ease on the eyelid, but it's not bad quality. I actually like that it's kind of sticky because we're not getting flaky falloutness, which sometimes is the case with the Melt shimmers. I find that they're so flaky that they fall all over your face instead of applying to the lid. This is a little bit stickier, so it's actually sticking to the eyelid. So I'm not mad at it because it actually looks super pretty, right? That's a pretty, pretty color. As much as I would love for that to be all over the lid, I've got to share the love. So we're gonna go into Bourbon next, which is a little bit of a warmer gold. It's interesting texture. They don't necessarily feel creamy. They actually are a harder press, but they're stickier. So what you do get, like, kind of sticks to the lid. It might take a little bit of work to get it to stick. So I definitely think you'll want to use a finger for this formulation. I love how textured this formula looks on the eyelid. It's really pretty. I'm taking my blender brush, blending out these edges. I will take Musk. How does this feel? This feels actually a little bit more creamy. It's definitely not the sticky texture like these two, which I think is a correction of those flaky shades that they have. It allows the formula to still look textured on the lid, but it doesn't have fallout. This is just actually like a true creamy kind of typical shimmer shade. And this works perfectly as an inner corner color. And I must say, this is like kind of a deeper base neutral palette with the types of shimmers that they give you, but it's really pretty. I want to add a little bit more of brunette, which is the darkest brown, along the lower lash line. Okay, I like this palette. This is not a fail at all from Melt. It's interesting, the formula of the shimmers are a little bit more different than what I'm used to, but they were pretty easy to apply. They look nice on the lids. The mattes blended nice. So this is one of the better Melt palettes. It's just a matter if you need this or not, which if you own a lot of makeup. You don't need it. It's a neutral palette, but it's one of Melt's better ones. I will say that. The formula in here is quite solid, so I'm happy with this. Let's move back to the cheeks, because I got these in an awesome PR package from Milani, and we have a cream blush trio and a powder blush trio. So let's start off with the cream. Kind of nervous at how these are going to act because I do have a powder on. I don't know if I should go with this shade. Is it too deep? I just like that it's a little bit more neutral than the other two. Let's swatch. Ooh, these feel kind of almost oily, like a little bit too slick, you know? But we'll try that one. I'm gonna take the end of my AOA sponge, trying to go pretty light because this is quite deep. Oh, this is actually quite pretty. And it doesn't seem to be fighting with the powders that I applied. And honestly, if this doesn't agree with the powders, I'm not gonna put blame on the product. I just need to try this product in a better setting. I do feel like it's kind of emphasizing a little bit of texture though on my cheeks. I mean, I wouldn't say it's sitting on the skin beautifully. It didn't exactly mesh into the skin very well, but it's not doing a bad job considering I packed on the powder before this. So I need to play with this one more, I would say. Try it out in different scenarios with products that I'm more familiar with, but I think it's okay. I don't dislike it, but I do want to set with a powder on top. So this is the Cheek Kiss Powder Blush Palette in Golden Hour Glow. And I would say the creams kind of line up pretty well. So we're gonna stick with the deepest shade. I'm gonna go back into the Iconic London brush that I used with the bronzer. Let's see, actually, is this pigmented? Yeah. Does have some pigment there, so light hand with the brush, especially since I already have a cream base underneath. Oh gosh, I knew this would happen. This might look really nice on a deeper skin tone, so I'm not mad that it's in the trio. This brush is a little dense, so she picks up a lot of color. Doesn't look like a smooth blend, does it? See, this is what happens when you try all new products together, you guys. You don't pair them with the best products sometimes. They aren't on their best behavior. Yeah, so these Milani products, I need to play with a little bit more. I'm excited about the concepts of these. They look like they could be really good, but I need to use them in a little bit more of an isolated situation as opposed to new on top of new on top of new. I also got a Jouer highlighter that I want to try out. They sent a PR package a while back, and I played with a lot of the products from that PR package, and I haven't jumped on trying this one just because I actually tried the Jouer highlights. Topaz is really pretty, and I actually believe I decluttered Topaz. But it's a really gorgeous formula, and I just decluttered Topaz because it was old, not because I didn't like it. So I really do like the Jouer highlight formulas. Nikki Tutorials years ago was the one that introduced me to Jouer highlights, and this was back in the day where everybody was looking for the best highlight. It was kind of not a new concept, but it wasn't as popular, so we were trying to find the good ones that were out. So you can see, very blinding Topaz is very much emphasizing whatever the heck I have going on my face right now, texture wise. It is what it is, you know? We all have texture. I don't get too caught up on the texture part, but you can see the texture. And yeah, very, very glowy highlights, as Jouer's are. They definitely had their moment in like 2018. I don't know, I'm kind of excited to have this back in my collection. A little nostalgic, you know? Let's quickly pop on a new eyeliner. I have this one from Essence. This is a waterproof eyeliner pen. I'm always on the lookout for a really good liquid liner pen, especially if it can be more affordable, because currently my favorite eyeliner pen is like $60. But this, let's see, I haven't tried it yet. So, hey, you know what? This is not bad. I do think though, it feels a little dry, so I do worry about the longevity of this, but if it's only a few bucks, I think it did a good job being drawn on. It was very easy to use. Lots of precision. We'll have to see how this wears and also how long it lasts just sitting in a makeup drawer. But very first use, I'm not mad about it. It's not too wet. Pretty good thing. So I'm going to do the other eye. I'm not opening up a new mascara right now because I have a drawer of mascaras I need to work through. I'm going to pop on some lashes and we're going to work on some lip products that I'm really excited to test out. So I wanted to dig into a pair of lashes that I hadn't worn in a while, and I pulled out the Pure and Raw Beauty Crispy Can't Be Bothered, and now I remember why I didn't dig into these because they kind of drag my eyes down because they're straight. I like lashes that curl because they, you know, open up the eyes, but anyways, they're on, so better than nothing though. Not my favorite. So I'm so excited because I really wanted to play again with my BK Beauty lip collection products. So Miss Lisa, the owner of BK Beauty, launched 4 lip liners and I believe 5 lipsticks. And I've used them before. They're very, very nice, but I still want to play with some new colors and combinations and all of that. I love Lisa. I love her company. I think all of her products are beautiful, literally perfection. I think the thing with her lip line though, the colors are very, very pink because I was going through what colors I wanted to wear. For this look, I was looking for something a little bit more brown, but we're definitely gonna have to go more pink just because that's what we have. So I'm going to apply the lip liner in the shade Warm Spice because this is the warmest we can get it. You see how easily this glides on? What a stunning formula. Very nice, super creamy. She has some really nice colors. Again, you can kind of see they're all a little bit more pink-based. This one is going to be the warmest color. And then the lipstick that I chose was Kindness. This is like a light nude kind of pinky shade. They feel super comfortable and they're quite customizable. Like, they're not too pigmented, but you can just swipe 3 times and then you have completely full opacity. And they look so luscious on the lips. I don't know if you can see, but they completely fill in all of the finer lines on the lips. So if you have a lot of lines on your lips, completely concealed them, which in return makes the lips look more plump. Oh my gosh, this formula is awesome. This is not my first time using these, but this is my first time like using them in front of the studio lights with an HD camera in front of my mirror, and wow. Really beautiful formula these are. What other colors did I want to try? This one is a little bit lighter. This is Self Love. It's a little bit more pink. I really hope she expands this lip line. It's a gorgeous formula. It feels quite luxurious. I mean, I'm excited in general to see Lisa expand her beauty line and her brushes because everything she's come out with so far has been stunning, but these lipsticks, it's hard to come across the lipsticks that literally make your lips look more full because they fill in the lines of the lips. Wow, I love that. Anyways, here's the final look from just playing around, and I actually ended up really liking this look. Everything looks good, which doesn't always happen when you put a bunch of random products together to see what happens, but not bad for a late night look, you know, just playing around with some new products. And you guys, this is the secret life of a YouTuber. This is what I do as a makeup reviewer to try and essentially keep up with all of the makeup. I say at the beginning of all of my videos, I'm a product knowledge enthusiast. I like to know about as much of the makeup on the market as I can, and I only got one face, so this is what I have to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this casual video, just playing around with some products that I've been needing to try out this evening. And a huge thank you to Shop Miss A for sponsoring today's video and letting me choose my favorite product from them to talk about. Literally, I specifically requested that I wanted to talk about this sponge, you guys. So make sure you click the link down below to check out my paw sponge. And yeah, if you guys aren't subscribed to my channel already, I would love it if you would consider taking the time to do so. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.